hear the name Barrio Fiesta, what comes to mind? You might be thinking of the restaurant chain, or perhaps the brand of bagoong you enjoy with your kare-kare. If it sounds familiar, it's because the brand has been around since 1952. Barrio Fiesta started as a chain of restaurants that became famous for its kare-kare and crispy pata. It wasn't long before the business also started catering to overseas Filipinos and their love of Pinoy food. For Filipinos, few flavors remind them of home as much as the humble bagoong, or what the rest of the world knows as shrimp paste. It's a staple in the Pinoy household, and while there are many different versions, the most popular one is arguably the original bagoong from Barrio Fiesta. It's not a secret that Filipinos, no matter where we are, love to eat, and that food is such a big part of our culture. In 2011, Dr. Rolando B. Hortaleza, a Filipino entrepreneur known for establishing a popular line of personal care brands in the country, acquired the Barrio Fiesta Manufacturing Corporation. This did not include the chain of restaurants. With his vision of bringing more Filipinos together through good food, Dr. Hortaleza bought the humble plant in Bulacan, where the famous alamang was sorted, cooked, and bottled. With the acquisition, several important changes were made, including updating the logo, which was meant to signify specialty cooking at home. Barrio Fiesta became a household name and brand that would expand to other food categories to cater to its growing market. A new line of bagoong products and other Pinoy pantry staples like fish sauce, peanut butter, and broth cubes were also introduced. These were distributed at scale, from local sari-sari stores to large supermarket chains and even to countries such as the United States, Canada, those in the Middle East, and Australia. Through the years, Barrio Fiesta has grown in leaps and bounds. It continues to break new ground, redefining the taste of home without forgetting what's really important. Bringing people together through their love of good food.
Hi, I'm Dr. Kenji. Here in KonsultaMD, our top priority is to provide 24/7 access to all our doctors. Here's how easy it is to talk to one of us. Download our app on Google Play, App Store, or the Huawei App Gallery, enter your mobile number to create your profile, and choose any of our services to get started.
Konsulta mo na yan!
Hello! How are you feeling today? Ikaw ba ay nalulungkot? Kinakabahan? Or may mga overwhelming emotions? Kumain ka na ba? Nakatulog ka ba ng maayos kagabi? Remember, it's okay to not be okay. You can call us up at KonsultaMD anytime. We can talk about it. Nandito kami para sa iyo.
everyone. Hi, good afternoon. This is Micaela Martinez, your host for today. And I'm super thrilled to be here with all of you, especially the mommies. I might see some familiar names right here. So please feel free to leave your comments in the comment section below. So today and this month is actually all about nutrition. And Barrio Fiesta is encouraging all the mommies to feed their kids with the right nutrients that they need and train them at an early age to live a healthy lifestyle. We understand how challenging this may be for us moms, but with Barrio Fiesta's Mani-namnam Peanut Butter, gaganahan talaga ang ating mga kids kumain ng masasarap at masustansyang pagkain. So for today's episode, we will cover topics such as the importance of Nutrition Month, the recommended nutrients for kids, and of course, effective ways to condition young children to develop healthy eating habits. Because you know, it has been a struggle, I think, because of all the junk food. And during this pandemic, it's like you get tempted to order here and there. So now we will help you get through this, right? This live segment will also feature healthy Mani-namnam recipes focused on snacks, desserts, incorporating peanut butter as the key ingredient. But before we proceed, we would like to show our gratitude to everyone for joining us today in our live stream. Everyone here will get 1 month free family health plan from KonsultaMD. How amazing is that? And more freebies from Barrio Fiesta. So make sure you stay tuned until the end of this live stream to learn more about these exciting prizes for you. We will be done in like an hour, so it's not very long. It will be worth it, and I'm sure you guys will enjoy. So, you know, before we proceed, I'd like to introduce our first guest for today. She is actually Miss Jana Clarice Ocampo, a nutritionist from AID. Miss Jana is a nutrition coach specializing in pediatric nutrition. She graduated from the University of the Philippines, Los Baños, and her passion can be rooted in her love for kids due to having little cousins and a virtual day job of being a freelance tutor. You can also find her practicing yoga or listening to her favorite K-pop boy group, GOT7, during her free time. So now we'd like to welcome Miss Jana.
Hi everyone, good afternoon, and it's so nice to be here. Nice to meet you, Micaela, and nice Hello. To see you all, everyone.
Thank you for being here. So Miss Jana here represents AID, which is a healthcare platform that provides reliable and affordable home care solutions and services to patients who are dealing with illnesses and injuries. So I'd like to open the floor to Miss Jana to share her little spiel about Nutrition Month and the topic of the day.
Thank you so much for that, Micaela. And I would like to share you all about Nutrition Month for today. So, every year, July is celebrated as Nutrition Month. Sobrang importante ng Nutrition Month. Parang birthday lang yan eh. Parang birthday na ganun ka-importante ang Nutrition Month. It's for us to be more aware of the importance of nutrition in our daily lives. Actually, fun fact lang, Nutrition Month started because of PD-491, which is also known as the Nutrition Act of the Philippines. And also, para sa mga chikiting, importante din ang Nutrition Month para i-remind din sa kanila na importante talaga ang proper nutrition at saka healthy diet. Kaya sa schools natin, merong mga program at merong mga times na, Mommy, pwede ba ako magsuot na parang gulay? Parang ganun na nga nangyayari sa atin ngayon. Noong face-to-face pa. Pero, as for this Nutrition Month, our theme is, next slide please, new normal na nutrition, sama-samang gawan ng solusyon. So, itong tema na to, it shows that we must strengthen our actions towards nutrition improvement as we shift towards the new normal. Ano nga ba yung new normal? Since ngayon, meron na sa COVID-19 pandemic po tayo, so itong life na to, kailangan na yung mabuhay na nandiyan ng pandemic. So, i-observe natin ang social distancing, wearing of masks, hand sanitizer, and frequent hand washing din po. So, meron huge impact on nutrition itong COVID-19 pandemic dahil tumataas na nga po yung hunger and malnutrition rates at saka nadidisrupt din ang delivering of nutrition services among others. Madami po yan at saka pati na rin po sa food security, food availability, and so on. So, pero may mga positive na impact o may mga magandang naidulot ng pandemya tungkol sa nutrition. Dahil dyan, nakakapag-deliver tayo ng pagkain kung saan-saan, nakakapag-consult tayo online sa mga ating mga doktor, at nagiging mas health-conscious tayo. Mas naging aware na po tayo kung na ito na dapat kainin natin. Minsan nga, nag-home gardening tayo para mga plantito at plantita, ganun. So, ganun na nga po yung nangyayari po ngayon. So, next slide please. So, para sa ating mga mommies, ito po ang ating key messages para tandaan niyo palagi. So, first of all, is to ensure proper nutrition to build body resistance against disease. Yung National Nutrition Council po, o yung number one na governing body of nutrition sa ating bansa, ay nagbigay po ng limang recommendations. Una sa lahat, sundan po natin ang pinggang Pinoy at na nakita niyo po sa screen at kumain ng wasto ng bugtong pagkain at may balance na balanse, may variety at saka in moderation. Pangalawa, kumain tayo ng gulay, green leafy vegetables o yung mga maberdeng madahon na gulay at saka yung mga rich in B vitamins. Pangatlo, maging physically active, mag-exercise palagi. Pang-apat, huwag uminom at iwasan din manigarilyo at saka ganun po. At pang-lima ay uminom ng 8 to 10 glasses of water kada araw. So, ayun po yung sa first key message. Sa pangalawang key message naman po, let us work together to end hunger and malnutrition for all families. So, dahil lahat tayo, isa tayong isang community. Lahat dapat tayo magtutulungan palagi. So, for example, pwede niyong tanungin yung fellow tita niyo or fellow mommy niyo kung nahihirapan kayo na pakain yung anak niyo. Moms, paano ko papakainin tong anak ko? Ayaw niyo sa lahat. Tapos tutulungan niyo po sila. Ganun po. Pwede din po magpa-consult din po sa iyong registered nutritionist dietitian tulad ko. Ganun pong mga senaryo po. At pangatlo po, do not ever forget this, is to continue to follow health protocols as prescribed by the government authorities and also the WHO and so on. So, yun lamang po ang masasabi ko po tungkol sa Nutrition Month. And thank you so much po.
Miss Jana, thank you so much for your insightful presentation, and all the information was very helpful. I'm sure all the mommies here and daddies could also relate. You know what I love about this community and the mom community is that we can all learn from each other. And you know, there are so many ways also online that we can learn. There's on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook even, of different ways we can allow our kids to eat healthily in creative ways. You know, sometimes you put the gulay and make it look like it's, you know, like an artwork in the food. There are so many different ways. And, you know, we all learn from each other. So I love that you reminded us about that. And I'm sure all of us will apply this in our daily lives, especially for our children. So yes, thank you again, Miss Jana. I will call you again later as we do Q&A. But first, I'd like to share with you, mommies, na ang Barrio Fiesta ay available hindi lamang sa lahat ng supermarkets nationwide, but also on Shopee and Lazada. All you need to do is visit Prime Global at Shopee and Lazada, and you can enjoy discounts by using their code PRIMEBF10. It's PRIMEBF10. Kaya ano pang hinihintay nyo? Add to cart na. And don't forget the Mani-namnam Peanut Butter, dahil tiyak na hindi ito pagsasawa ng mga kids sa dami ng variants na pagpipilian nila. At dahil dyan, Barrio Fiesta is feeling extra generous today. Get a chance to win Barrio Fiesta products by sharing our live stream and tagging 3 of your mom friends. All you need to do is share the live stream and tag 3 of your mom friends. And then at the end of this live stream, we will announce 3 winners. So what are you waiting for? Time to share. Bilis, bilis. We have a few more minutes. And don't forget to stay until the end because we have a lot of exciting giveaways for all of you. So I would like to call on actually our next guest. And, you know, she is from KonsultaMD because we have a very meaningful discussion today. And I know that she will give very important information because Dr. Myrtle Ballester is a pediatrician who was in practice for 10 years now and has been a board certified specialist since 2014. She took up medicine in USD and had her training at the Manila Doctors Hospital. She became part of ConsultaMD in 2020, and you can find her enjoying time at the beach, either snorkeling or scuba diving in her free time. So we'd like to call on Dr. Myrtle.
Hello, Michaela, and thank you for that kind introduction. Thank you for inviting me again. And hello to all the viewers na mga nanonood ng Barrio Fiesta Live.
Yeah, so Dr. Myrtle is actually from ConsultaMD, which is the number one telehealth membership service that allows you to have 24/7 unlimited access to licensed doctors with no appointment needed. And with this, we'd like to also welcome Jana back on screen because we are going to be doing a Q&A. And I'm sure a lot of you mommies here in the comment section and daddies as well have a lot of interesting questions. But first, we are going to I have some questions actually that I'd like to ask you. So Dr. Myrtle, how do you convince children to stay healthy in the most natural way possible without putting too much pressure on them? Kasi alam mo naman, minsan children are very stubborn. Yes. They don't like to be told. So how do we do that seamlessly?
Yeah, it's a good question. Yung mga bata kasi ay naturally, they're really curious and they're really, they need it, they need food to grow. So they can't help it but to go in that direction. So the problem is yung mga preference nila, lalo na in the ages of mga 2 to 5 years old, that's when they really develop their preferences. And that's when you really play a major role. Yung mga caregivers natin, mga nanay natin, tatay natin, or other primary caregivers na available. So help them to learn to love a variety of food. So, syempre, you have to make some budget then, no, to have a variety of food available in the family. And then, lead an example to them, no? Kasi if they see you eating fruits and vegetables or any being healthy like crunching or having some exercises at home and enjoying it, I'm sure they'll join in. And then, of course, they're quite curious, so you have to introduce to them healthy foods one at a time. So yung mga familiar food mixed with new food that are beneficial for them. If you really want to you know, kasi some are picky, no? So that's their nature, but that doesn't mean that they won't like it. So you have to be patient with children. Kailangan talaga tiyagain ninyo, no? And sooner or later they'll warm up to the food because it's them, you know? And number 5, praise them when they try. Diba? Yes. Kasi syempre you have to it's not like coercing them or pipilitin mo sila kumain. Pero if they try, syempre you have to reinforce yung mga positive behaviors and don't use food as a reward. Yun. No? So syempre, 'di ba? May ugali tayo, 'di ba? Okay, mommy will give you chocolate. Mm. Or do you want manipulator? Ay, diba? So sometimes parang it has a message that when you do this, you will get a reward, and that reward parang fast food are actually good, or sweets are actually good. So maybe you can use other rewards like toys or educational toys or maybe a vacation. Yeah. So that's the it's not naman most natural, but you know, you have to play with their behavior, their curiosity, mixed with the really good options available at home. So yun.
That's true, Dr. Myrtle. I like what you shared. Very helpful indeed. Sometimes we need to be reminded of these things, you know. And now, Jana, I actually have a question for you, because since we are talking about our favorite Barrio Fiesta peanut butter, is it true that will our children get diabetes from eating too much peanut butter? How many servings of peanut butter should they consume per day?
Actually, you don't get diabetes from getting too much peanut butter, because diabetes is a result of unhealthy lifestyle, not eat too much eating of sugary foods, and not being active. So it's just a unison of many factors. So eating peanut butter too much, it's fine, but if you are doing an unhealthy lifestyle, then that might contribute to non-communicable diseases such as diabetes. I actually learned this from somewhere, but you have your thumb here. So this is like one serving of peanut butter that you have to eat per day. So for kids, you can just use one thumb. And for adults, you can just use a thumb as a measurement. So actually, it is like 1 to 2 tablespoons. But since we do not have the utensils at home, you can just use your thumb.
That is very helpful. So mommies, don't worry. Having peanut butter is not bad and it will not lead to diabetes. In fact, it's very healthy. So now, Dr. Myrtle, I actually have another question. How do we strengthen children's immune system besides making them drink vitamins?
So that's a good question, especially now that we're in a pandemic and hopefully it wanes, no? Children are naturally vulnerable to a lot of diseases because their immune system ay hindi pa ganun ka-mature, no? Unlike us, no? So, number one, kung yung age range natin is between 0 to 6 months, talagang ini-encourage namin yung breastfeeding because your breast milk, the mom's breast milk actually have natural immunoglobulins to fight off yung mga viruses and even bacterial infection. And less din yung incidence ng pneumonia, cough and colds, or pneumonia, or yung mga gastroenteritis. Now, when they go to, when they step into para mga 6 months onwards, dyan na mag-i-introduce tayo ng food. So it's important that, of course, it's a trial and error for every kid. Every kid has their own temperament. So, dito natin makikilala yung mga bata kung ano talaga yung ano nila, challenges nila and yung strengths nila in eating food. Some are very good in really taking in as much variety as they can. Some don't. No? So, for those who do not, no, doesn't mean naman na ano sila, no, hopeless. It's just that they had to be taken care of in a longer time before they can get used to the food, no? And when you have concerns about eating, for example, gusto niya, meron akong pasyente, talagang gusto niya peanut butter. Pero yun lang kinakain niya. So that's also worse, right?
Of course, parang
gusto lang niya is parang champurado or spaghetti or chicken lang. So, syempre, it's also a problem, no? Because yung immunity naman natin, it actually really relies on the natural food, whole food, no? Yes. If you can start with the whole food, that's better. Processed food, siguro secondary na lang kung talaga hindi tayo makapag-prepare at home. Pero I really wanna highlight whole food because yung mga enzymes natin, yung protein natin, doesn't have to be expensive, no? Itlog naman, di expensive eh. Milk that, of course, a lot of people want to have DHA and a lot of immune boosting, ano naman. Pero for me, whole food is the best na ano na immune booster, no? And of course, vitamins, if talagang hindi makakain ng gusto yung bata, you can really supplement until such time na kaya na nila to really have that. And of course, for mommies, it's a challenge, pero kinakailangan din talaga ninyong mag-isip, no, kung ano yung mga may meal plan tayo eh, na we can, ano. I'm sure Jana is familiar with the meal plan. A 1 week meal plan would be the best, no, para malaman mo kung meron bang fruits, vegetables, may ano ba siya, protein source syempre pag kids would be eggs and milk talaga. It's really the best, no, kung may allergy siya, it could be poultry, no, and pork and beef. So yun, so the protein is really the primary source of immune builders natin. And of course, sunlight exposure and exercise. So yes. Yun, no? So everything, it's all available. You don't have to be expensive supplements. It's all available in our surroundings and in the market. So yun. So I encourage the moms here na talagang gawin yung mga yun.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Mertel. Actually, in relation to that, Ms. Jana, I have a question for you. How should one portion a healthy balance of carbohydrates, protein, vitamins, and minerals during, you know, for the child's meal? Like sometimes, is there too much chicken, too much fish? What would be the best balance for a child's meal?
Okay, luckily, DOST FNRI developed a thing called Pinggang Pinoy. So the Pinggang Pinoy is divided into four parts. So there is one fourth for protein, like meat, fish, and chicken. And also, like, there's like almost one third. I can show a picture if I can. I cannot see. Anyways, so there's one third for go foods such as rice, since rice is the staple of every Filipino. So you can put like one third for rice. Then the other one third is for the vegetables. And also there's also the fruit portion, which is the remaining portion on top. So that's how we usually segment or divide our plate. And always remember that we must have go, grow, and glow foods. So in go foods naman, ay rich in carbohydrates, which is the energy-giving sources. Habang naman yung grow foods, para maging bodybuilding foods na para lumaki tayo na maayos, at siya yung glow foods, which is the body regulating, para sa ating kagandahan, at saka para umano, para yung body processes natin ay maayos naman po sila. And do not forget to add water or milk. Yun po.
Okay, that's very helpful. Okay, thank you for that, Jana. Dr. Myrtle, I have another question actually. Because, you know, we have some children that like to overeat, and then there are also some children who don't have much gana. That's why we have, you know, vitamins to make them eat more. Ganun. So what are the indicators of this when a child is eating less, or when they're eating enough or too much? How do we go about that?
Yeah. So let me just emphasize yung caregiver's role, no? In feeding. So actually the child actually has the say on how much he wants the food. You just have to but you can't go wrong with fruits and vegetables. But you can limit the sweets. Meron tayong I just want to share yung 5-2-1-0 principle. So 5-2-1 is 5 servings of fruits and vegetables in a day. So if you're not I'm sure if you serve 5 times ng fruits and vegetables in a day, they won't overeat. So that's the you can add carbohydrates, you can add protein, but we encourage you to really add more fiber, add more color to the food. And then number 2 is 2 hours of screen time. So that means when they 2 hours of screen time, that means they have to play with the rest of the day, or do other activity that would not involve any screen. That means TV, computer, and so you have to really have a good routine. And then 1 hour of physical activity. So 0, no caffeine, no sweets. So yun lang, mommies. Pag nalaman nyo lang yun, I'm sure you can't go wrong. And para kunwari, if you give them too much rice kasi like but if you give them too much protein, ganyan, parang ganyan, hindi ka magkakamali pagka inuna mo yung vegetables and then pagkatas yung ulam tsaka yung kanin ganyan, or yung lugaw ganyan. So you have to add you won't overeat if you first give yung fruits and vegetables. Yun siya.
True. And dapat balance talaga of everything, no? Kasi sometimes we think just because protein is good, puro protein na lang, or because fish is good, puro fish. It really is a balance of everything. Balance. No?
So yeah, it stems that. from the previous studies kasi na ang composition talaga ng diet natin ngayon, including children, no, sad to say, are protein and carbohydrates. And nawala talaga yung fiber. So this rule, it's not really a hard and fast rule, but it just wants to promote the incorporating. Even yung pangpinggang pinon, if you can see, yung shinare ni Jana, half nung plate natin will be fiber. So that means fruits and vegetables. That's how important it is. And may mga questions like gut health and everything. You know what? Just stick to the basic. Just stick to whole food and you'll never go wrong. So wag muna process. Wag muna fast food. Shan, yan siya.
That's true. Reminders, mommies. And the thing is, we also have to lead by example because we can't say naman to our children, don't eat that, don't eat that. Pero we're there in front of the TV eating cake, sugar, all of that. So our kids will just mimic. So we have to be mindful of that, to lead by example. I think that's my takeaway from all of this. No? Yeah. So yes, that ends our Q&A for now. But later on, we will be taking questions from the audience. So I will call you back later, Ms. Jana and Dr. Myrtle. Thank you so much for that very insightful Q&A. So now I'd like to give our audience another giveaway. So guys, I'm just reminding you that ConsultaMD is giving everyone a free family health plan, good for 1 month. Wow. And all you need to do, wait, imagine, not just for you, but for 5 members of the family. And to claim this gift, all you need to do is download the ConsultaMD app now by scanning the QR code on screen and then input the promo code Nutrition Month. Imagine you have 1 month free from ConsultaMD. What a great deal. So guys, don't forget to download the app right now by scanning the QR code and type in Nutrition Month. Thank you again, ConsultaMD, for being so generous. I'm sure all our moms here will enjoy that and really benefit from your app. So now we'd like to continue by giving you some quick trivia. Did you know that there's more to Barrio Fiesta's peanut butter than being just a spread? Considering how it is rich in nutrients that can boost one's energy and increase brain performance, it's perfect to integrate it with your children's meals. With that being said, this whole experience would not be complete without seeing Barrio Fiesta's products in action. So allow us to share with you an easy-to-follow recipe featuring Mani-namnam Peanut Butter in which your kids will surely enjoy. Watch this. That looks so good. Did you mommies enjoy that? Look how easy it was to make. And later on, we'll be sharing you more recipes for that. So now we'd like to proceed to Q&A again, but this time with you, the audience. And so mommies, please don't forget to don't hesitate to comment your questions below. You know, you can ask us about anything regarding nutrition and health and food. Our guest speakers here would love to answer them. So we would like to wait for more questions to come in and then we will read them and Dr. Myrtle and Ms. Jana will answer them. So please feel free to type in your questions below while we wait. And also don't forget, please share the live stream and tag 3 of your mommy friends to win the Barrio Fiesta giveaway, which we will announce shortly. So please continue to share the live stream. And then also we will ask, we'll have a Q&A right now with Dr. Myrtle and Jana Ocampo. So mommies, please feel free to leave a question below if you have any at all. Okay. Since while waiting, I actually might have a question. Okay, so here, because I know that a lot of kids actually can be underweight. So how do we feed the child to gain a little weight, but at the same time, maintain the healthy kind of weight? Hindi naman yung overweight. Kasi I think sometimes Filipinos think that just because the child is chubby or on the bigger side, malusog, diba? But it doesn't necessarily mean that, because that can also lead to other sicknesses. So how do we keep the balance of the weight of the child na healthy pa rin? What should we feed them? Ganun.
Doctora,
you want? Yeah, for children, if you mean parang mga toddlers, no, for us to be objective about it, they are expected to gain weight mga 4 to 6 pounds a year. So yan. So if it's beyond that, baka dun na tayo sa pathologic weight gain. Pero weight gain is actually natural for children. And then, pag nandun naman sa baba, meron tayong chart na growth chart, yung tinatawag. So, it has a wide variety of acceptable weight. So, mommies, I'd like to assure you na kailangan nyo po magkonsulta before you label your child as underweight or overweight. Baka rin payat lang or parang yung physique niya mismo. No? But kung pasok pa siya doon, we will not call that underweight. Pero if yung payat na payat talaga, we have to rehabilitate, maybe hospitalize. Pero if not naman, parang if in their peers, parang they're just parang behind. So there's also genetic factor with that. Pero kung all things being normal, I think we need just to prioritize first yung protein source natin. It should be healthy. So, eggs and milk, I cannot overemphasize. And then, protein like chicken, beef, or pork, it's important also. So, and then add to that fiber. So, sweets, you have to stay away. And then, yung sa choice of carbohydrates, siguro, more of yung whole. Like, whole kamote, ganyan, no? There's no shame in giving your child kamote. So, or like, basaba, ganon. Instead of, like, burger or, peanut butter is fine, I think. But it's in combination with some fruits siguro and vegetables. So, we have to be creative lang. And you have to limit lang yung may mga ano sweets na parang you have to limit also. If you're giving sweets as a snack, don't add na a sweet beverage. Siguro just add water. Mm-hmm. So, that's it. No? So, just to minimize yung sweet intake nila, because it would eventually turn out that they'll be, you know, gaining weight.
Just to add what Dr. Myrtle said, us nutritionists also have child growth standards where we can show which one, how, if the it's healthy weight gain or if it's over the charts. So actually, if it's overweight, it is recommended, if it's in the pathologic overweight already, it's recommended to lose at least 1 pound per month, because it is while the child is growing, it's not really recommended for weight loss. But when it's underweight, really just provide them with whole foods and also protein. I also agree with Dr. Myrtle said about eggs and milk. Yun lang.
Okay, thank you for that, Ms. Jan and Dr. Myrtle. And I believe we have a lot of questions popping in, so we'd like to give the next question from our viewer. This is from Ira Del Pilar. Any tips for new moms in terms of kickstarting their children's healthy lifestyle at an early age? Would anyone like to answer this?
For me, I would just like to say that there are a lot of resources that can help you kickstart their children's healthy lifestyle. Basta yung pagkakatiwalaan mismo, hindi lang bisto sa ibang tao. Just like us, ako at si Dr. Myrtle, we're professionals. So kami ang mag-guide sa inyo para dun sa, if you're not sure of what you read, professionals will guide you on how to kickstart your healthy lifestyle at an early age. So, Dr. Myrtle, may sasabihin pa po kayo?
Yeah, oo. I think the the battle is here in the urban setting. Because if you're in somewhere in the province, parang it's easier to have like a playground or a parang a good space for your physical activity. So that's number one. Mm-hmm. So you have to have like, kasi sometimes we settle with tablets and phone just to babysit, quote unquote. No, they are very useful, but sometimes they can be very distractive early on in children. So for ages 5 years and below, actually, if you want to be strict about it, no tablets talaga siya. So anong papalit mo doon, di ba? So you can have blocks, toys, and then mga coloring books, no, that would really stimulate also in developmental milestones nila, no, and their curiosity. You could get them to play outside. So mm-hmm. that's the healthy lifestyle, number one. And number two, in terms of nutrition, at age one, the child is supposed to be tolerating also yung table food. So anything that is put on the table that the whole family eats, they're expected to also eat it in a small portions lang. Ganon siya. So if their choices are limited, you know, kung talagang medyo hindi variety yung walang masyadong variety yung choices niya. When I mean variety is that may inclusion siya ng fresh fruits and vegetables every day, and then meat, fish, and chicken, eggs, no. So that would play a big part. So so mommy, I bless your creativity kasi kinakailangan talaga magplano. Magplano kayo kung ano yung kakainin niya, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and a child needs a routine. So that That's means true. Kasi hindi sila yung parang mag-iisip sila ng sarili nila, I want to be healthy. No. They have a schedule. So ang tip ko sa inyo, for example, it's playtime and daytime. Schedule it before lunch. Yun. Para gutom siya. Tapos kung ano yung papakain nyo sa kanya. Syempre, because
they'll
of
eat
the
it.
hunger, he'll eat it. So, to schedule the, if you wanna introduce a new food to them, for example, you want some carrots or broccoli in their diet, kaya lang parang hindi pa sila sanay. So, you can schedule the food pagkayong after playtime. Para meron silang natural hunger for food, whatever you offer. So yun.
Yeah, and then you have that,
yeah. And you have to also, pagka, for example, they also have to make a choice. Pero actually, both choices are healthy. So for example, like oranges or apples or say fish or chicken, it's both good for them. But you have to also give them the chance to choose, quote unquote, what they want. So yun, mga ganun.
Yes, actually, I mean, if I could share also, because I have three kids, I have two teenagers and then 1 6-year-old. And I think, you know, whatever you have, like, it's a grocery, diba? So we moms, well, in our case, I do the grocery. If you buy all chips and chocolate, they will eat what's there. But if you lessen mm-hmm. that and buy more of fruits or healthier things to snack on, it will also mm-hmm. make them easier to eat that, kasi they will eat what's available, diba?
Yeah, yeah.
So, yun. So, again, it's leading by example. Okay, yeah. And then I think we have more questions coming in. So, our next question is from Jen Miranda. Hi, Dr. Martel and Ms. Jana. What can you advise to parents who have a picky eater? Ooh, I'm sure a lot of moms can relate to this.
Yes.
Aww. Yes. So, wow. Okay. Sige po. For me, for picky eater children, we must introduce, kung ayaw niya talaga kumain, we must introduce the food a bit at a time. So, sabi po Dr. Myrtle kanina, yung mga favorite, yung mga familiar siya na food, tapos inject niyo po yung new food. Tapos, unti-unti niyo, hanggang sa magustuhan niya. It also takes patience din kasi. So, kung ayaw niya talaga at the first try, try again at the second try. Hanggang sa magustuhan niya din in the end. And also, we must also, as said earlier as well, lead by example.
Yeah.
Kung kumakain ng mga mommies at saka yung buong family ng masasarap ng fruits and vegetables, ganun, makakain din siya eventually. And also, one tip, pag nagta-tantrum si yung bata, pag nasa-tantrum siya, usually, ano, Like what pag nag-attention si bata, ano? The kid shall decide when to eat and what and how much she should eat. So we must respect also that the child can also have the responsibility on their hunger cues. Dr. Myrtle, explain po kayo.
Yeah, oo. Picky eater is a very common problem. You know what, according to the experts, no, sabi ng mga gastroenterologist, you see, a kid is picky eater when you already have offered, what, 20 items of food. Okay, number one, mommy, have you offered 20 items of food to the child? If not, he's not a big eater. You have a limited variety of food. Yon, no? So, mommy, you have to be, I know it's really very hard. Siyempre, kailangan natin ng budget, no? And, pero, this would go a long way if you have a variety of available food for you, for the family actually, no? Especially yung mga fruits and vegetables and things. Filipino food are very rich naman, no? So you have to also try. Wag muna fast food, oo. Yes. And wag muna yung mga processed food like prito-prito lang ng kung ano, no? You just have to try whole food. Whole food, kamote, yan, like gabi, banana, dragon fruit, yung mga variety like papaya. It has to be a variety of food before picky eating. Now, tama yung kay Jana that you have to be patient. According to the experts, some kids are really very choosy, but sometimes when you introduce your food, a good kid would like eat it right away, but some they want una aamuin muna nila yan or just touch it. So i-ano mo lang sa kanya, i-offer mo lang sa kanya. You have to offer the food up to 12 to 14 times before you say na ayaw niya. So, naka-offer ka na ba ng ganon? 15 times? No, di ba? And then, when you offer first, syempre, amoy-amoyin muna, natatouch-touch muna niya. They can play with it, no? Sayang. But, until such a time that they can acclimatize, warm up na dun siya sa food, and then, pwede niya na talaga kainin. So, may mga ganong relationship, yung food tsaka yung bata. So, it really takes time and patience. Pero, if you want to develop that, they don't have a choice because you're their parent. No? And talagang kung ano yung, because you have the, ano naman, authority to really offer them and the choices that they have. So there, I just want to encourage you to number one is variety. The key is variety. So yun lang. Don't lose hope. No, hindi pa siya picky niyan.
Thank you for that. And I'm sure we have more questions here. We'd like to answer as much questions as we can. So the next question here is from Bernadette Tokau. I am allergic to shrimp and crabs, and I know I can't prevent my child from eating 100% of the time. My question is, what should I do to handle my allergy? Not sure if my baby has the same allergy as mine.
So you want, Clara, you want to give your child shrimp and crabs? Is that what the okay.
Yeah, I think so. How does she handle her allergy? Kasi parang baka the child also will react the same way.
Okay. So number one, she won't miss out on shrimp and crabs if you don't give it. Kasi marami pa namang pwede, di ba? Baka mamaya kayong dalawa na yung mag-allergy. Kasi allergic pala siya, especially if you have history. So, di naman natin nililimit to ano. Pero, you won't miss out on any vital proteins or nutrients if you eliminate shrimp and crabs or any seafood, ganun. Kung talagang allergy po kayo. So that's our priority. Mm-hmm. Your safety is our priority number one. So and hindi niya hanapin kung hindi niya natikman. So
that's true. Yeah. Yes. Okay, and then we have another question from another mommy over here. Catherine Sikat. Dr. Myrtle and Miss Jana, paano po kayo maiiwas ang mga anak ko sa junk foods, hot dogs, fried chicken, and sweet. Palagi po kasi yan ang gusto. Lumalaki ng mga tonsils niya, health.
And junk foods, first of all, ilimit natin yung junk foods, or yung availability ng junk foods, hot dogs, fried chickens, and sweet. So, iwasan, wag niyong ipakita masyado. Like, ma, nasan yung junk food? Wala nang junk food, anak. Kailangan mong kumain ito. Kailangan ganun.
True. Yung, kailangan may bola-bola.
Yeah, wala nang junk food. Ganyan. So, actually, ano, there are two types of food, nabasa ko. Is there's everyday food and sometimes food. So, yung sometimes food, kasama dun yung mga junk food and hot dog and all that you mentioned. So, we do not like to restrict, like, wag mo na siyang kainin all the time. So we just have to give it like once a month or something like that. Just only sometimes. Not every time. Para masanay din siya sa ibang pagkain, kumbaga.
That's true. It becomes their habit kasi, no?
Yes, it becomes their habit.
Yeah. Okay, and that wraps up our Q&A. Thank you, mommies, for all your questions. And of course, we'd like to thank our guest speakers, Ms. Jana and Dr. Myrtle, for joining us today and for helping us moms gain a better understanding of our children's health and nutrition. Last but not the least, we'd like to thank Barrio Fiesta for giving us this wonderful opportunity to learn about these things. So thank you again, Ms. Jana and Dr. Myrtle. We'll see you again next time. So, oh my gosh, mommies, I can't believe that, you know, this is coming to an end. But, you know, we got to discuss so many things in just a short period of time. And, you know, as much as we wanted to answer so many more of your questions, we have to end the session here. But don't worry, because this will not be the end of our Mani-namnam series. We have another episode next Saturday at 3 p.m. As we discuss how Gen Zs can address their mental health concerns through proper nutrition and healthy eating habits. I'm sure a lot of you mommies can relate to this. So that is next Saturday at 3 p.m. But before we wrap up things today, Barrio Fiesta would like to give you more freebies. Who wants more freebies? Of course we do. Grabe, sobrang generous ng Barrio Fiesta. Ang daming pa-surpresa para sa ating mga mommies. So 6 lucky winners will have the chance to win up to 2,000 pesos cash prize plus a Barrio Fiesta gift pack. Imagine that, may takeaway ka na, may cash prize ka pa just by watching this live stream. And all you have to do is follow Barrio Fiesta Foods on TikTok and Instagram and Barrio Fiesta Official on Facebook and show us your best hashtag peanut takam recipe using Mani-namnam peanut butter, either by posting a photo of your dish and placing the recipe on the caption, or through a step-by-step video running us through the whole process of creating your dish. You can also do both. Speaking of that, I actually posted my own on TikTok. It's at Micaela Martinez with 3 Z's. I did a no-bake peanut butter recipe. And I am not good in the kitchen, I have to admit. Sobrang hindi ako magaling talaga magluto. And pero I was able to do it using my favorite peanut butter from Barrio Fiesta. O, di ba? May plug pa. May baon talaga ako dito because I get hungry when I do live streaming and all of that. So, may baon ako dito sa given. But anyway, guys, don't forget that you can use Barrio Fiesta creamy and sweet, creamy and nutty, extra thick and creamy, and extra thick and nutty peanut butter. And post your creation on TikTok, Instagram, and Facebook and use the hashtags Barrio Fiesta Foods, hashtag Mani-namnam, and hashtag peanut takam recipe on your post. And then you tag 2 friends, and then make sure your profiles are in public so that Barrio Fiesta will be able to see your posts. We are giving away prizes to 6 winners that will be announced on August 1. So after this live stream and you get inspired, you can shop on Shopee, Lazada, and buy your ingredients, and then post your entry on your digital platforms. So yeah, that's it for today. Let's make our children's lives peanut better with Barrio Fiesta. Mani-namnam peanut butter is available in all 4 flavors. Kaya bili na kayo sa Shopee, Lazada, or sa mga supermarket na malapit sa inyo. And you will get to enjoy discounts when you purchase Barrio Fiesta products on Shopee by using the code PRIMEBF10, P-R-I-M-B-F-10. And don't forget to claim your 1-month health plan from ConsultaMD by downloading their app and using the promo code NUTRITIONMONTH. And as promised, I am announcing the winners of the Barrio Fiesta product kits for today. Here, let me get the names. Okay, we would like... Okay, so let me announce the winners. The three winners of the Barrio Fiesta product kits today. You know, don't forget to contact Barrio Fiesta Food's official Facebook page by sending your name, contact number, and your address. Okay, but these are the winners for today. We have Valen Sebastian is the first winner. Valen or Tess Sebastian. Congratulations. So, Miss Tess Sebastian, don't forget to message Barrio Fiesta Official on Facebook to claim your prize. And then we have the second winner. We have Marie Storefranca Del Valle. Congratulations. Thank you so much for sharing the stream and tagging your friends. And then, of course, our last winner for today, we have Grace Gumapo, our third winner for today. Don't forget to message your name and address on Barrio Fiesta Official on Facebook, and then they will reach out to you so you can claim your prize. Again, we want to thank you all for watching and participating. We wish you and your kids to stay safe and happy at all times. You know, happy Nutrition Month, everyone. Don't forget. And before we go, don't forget to use your Barrio Fiesta voucher on Shopee and Lazada. It is Prime BF10, and of course to download the KonsultaMD app to avail of your 1 month health plan. Thank you to our KonsultaMD family and of course Barrio Fiesta for all your giveaways today. And thank you most of all to all our viewers today. Without you, this wouldn't be successful. So thank you again for having me. This is Micaela Martinez, your host. Please follow me as well on Instagram and on TikTok. And I'll see you guys on our next stream. Bye.
Hi, I'm Dr. Kenji. Here in KonsultaMD, our top priority is to provide 24/7 access to all our doctors. Here's how easy it is to talk to one of us. Download our app on Google Play, App Store, or the Huawei App Gallery. Enter your mobile number to create your profile and choose any of our services to get started.
Konsulta mo na yan.
Hello. How are you feeling today? Ikaw ba ay nalulungkot? kinakabahan, or may mga overwhelming emotions? Kumain ka na ba? Nakatulog ka ba ng maayos kagabi? Remember, it's okay to not be okay. You can call us up at KonsultaMD anytime. We can talk about it. Nandito kami para sa'yo.
Thank you.